Hey everybody, in today's video, I'm gonna show you how to raise your prices by becoming the specialist. And if you like videos like this, then go ahead and subscribe to the channels because I release new videos on how to grow your business each and every week.
Hi, I'm Dan Henry. I used to deliver pizza and sell water bottles to pay my rent. Then I discovered entrepreneurship and grew a $20 million online business. Subscribe to my channel and I'll show you how.
Hey everybody, Dan Henry here, founder of GetClients.com. Today we're gonna talk about how to raise your prices. It doesn't matter if you have a done-for-you or agency service, maybe you're a web designer, maybe you're an accountant, maybe you sell online courses, or maybe you sell consulting. You can raise your prices if you learn to become a specialist. And that's what I'm going to cover today. And I'm gonna give you a couple examples so you can really sink your teeth into why it's okay and why people are willing to pay you more when you go more of a specialist route in your business rather than a generalist. By the way, please, go ahead and smash that like button because if you don't, this entire building is going to explode in 5 seconds and then I won't be able to finish the video and then you won't learn. So smash that like button right now. All right, so the truth is that specialists in almost all forms of life in anywhere you can find it, they always get paid more. Specialists make more, okay? They always make more. I'll give you some examples. Let's say you go to the doctor and you go to your primary care doctor. What's your copay? Your copay is like 20 bucks, maybe 50 bucks if your insurance isn't so good. And that's because that is a general practitioner. It's a primary doctor. You scrape your knee, you fall, you have any sort of small issue, they're going to take care of you. But if you have anything else, like let's say you break your leg and it's a big issue, you gotta go to a specialized doctor for that. They're gonna take x-rays and I think that's called an orthopedic. Or let's say you have cancer, you're gonna have to go to, you know, a doctor that specializes in cancer. There are so many doctors that specialize in different parts of the body. Now, what happens when you go to a specialist? You go and you pay like a $200, $300 copay. Why? Because those doctors charge more. Why do they charge more? Because they specialize in one thing. The doctor that gets paid to deal with your scraped knee is gonna get this much. The doctor that gets paid to help you cure your cancer obviously can demand a higher price. Here's some examples of how this would work in a non-doctor world, because doctors pretty much get to set their price. They don't really have to work hard to charge that. But if you wanna charge more, let me give you some examples. So let's say you're a web designer, all right? And you're like, all right, I design websites. Now let's say you charge $1,500 to design a website for somebody because you're a general web designer. Now imagine for a moment that you became a specialist and you only designed e-commerce websites, right? That's all you did. You became the best at that. You learned all the little tricks of the trade and all the things that really made e-commerce websites really shine. Or even if it wasn't e-commerce, maybe it's a law website. Like maybe you specialize in law websites so that when a prospect goes to a law website, they really, really are encouraged to book a call with that lawyer more so than a general law site because you've done it so many times. Every single client you worked with is a lawyer and you've really sunk your teeth into that and become good at that. Well, now if you're a generalist and a lawyer comes over to you and says, well, I want you to design my website. Okay, I charge $1,500. If you're a specialist and you design law websites, you could demand more like 5 to 10 grand. Why? Why is that? Well, think about this. If you want your website designed, would you rather pay this much for somebody who does all kinds of different websites, or would you rather pay a little bit more, or really a lot more, for somebody that specializes? Just as if you went and you got into an accident. What kind of lawyer do you hire? You hire a personal injury attorney. You don't hire a general attorney. If the government dumps toxic waste on your land, you hire an environmental attorney. You don't go to your local family law attorney. And when you're a specialist, you just get paid more. It's just the way life works. So again, you know, I'm not gonna go pay a general practitioner to operate on my heart. I'm gonna pay a heart doctor. Here's another example. I had an issue with my heart. I had a condition called WPW, Wolff-Parkinson's-White syndrome. I went to a cardiologist and they gave me some tips And they said, well, you know, this or that. But I eventually went to the next step and I went to an electrophysiologist, which is like the next step up in heart doctors for anything electrical in your heart. And that doctor said, listen, it could be an issue and I can operate it and I can fix it. Now that cost me $30,000 to fix my heart out of pocket because at the time my business was just growing and I didn't even have insurance because I couldn't afford it the year before and I was locked out of the enrollment period. So I had to, if it wasn't for my business, I wouldn't have been able to pay that. So that doctor got paid way more because he specialized in just one part of the heart. And I would have much rather had him work on my heart because it's my heart than a general cardiologist. So do you see the point? So if you're an accountant and you charge $500 a month to be a general accountant, let's say you only dealt with lawyers, or you only dealt with e-commerce sites, or you only dealt with restaurants, or you only dealt with bars, you could charge a lot more. If I own a restaurant and I want to save the most money possible in taxes, I'm going to hire a restaurant-specific CPA rather than a general CPA. In fact, my CPA that I use personally specializes in internet companies, specializes in people that do what I do. I literally got my tax rate from the high teens to the low 20s down to 6.5% last year because I switched from a general CPA to a CPA that specialized in internet companies like mine. And she cost far more. She cost $30,000-ish, whereas the other one cost like five. So I paid $25,000 more, but I ended up saving like $2.5 million more in taxes. So I don't care. And that's the thing. People don't care when they are asked to pay more if it's a specialist because they know the value of that specialist. So if you're an accountant, if you're a web designer, if you're a marketing agency that helps people grow their business, if you're a consultant, if you're a course creator, whatever it is that you are, if you want to charge more and get a yes easier, specialize. Specialize, specialize, and then you can raise your prices and you can have a much healthier business and a much lower stress business as a result, okay? If you need any help, my company, GetClients.com, specializes in teaching people how to sell their products, services, or advice for a high ticket and premium price and how to attract the right clients. So I'll leave a link below where you can check out how to become a client or just go to GetClients.com. We have tons of free resources, podcasts, a webinar, free books and all kinds of jazz. So check that out. And also don't forget to subscribe to the channel. You don't want to miss yet another video. Let me know in the comments, what do you do? What do you do and what do you charge? I'd love to know because I'm pretty sure you can add a zero to it. I'll see you in the next video.